Hi everyone, my name is Dan. My story is related to my brother Evan. We're siblings. We have a lot of interests in common. And in general, we've always gotten along together, but we were still very different, too different. And then one day, he decided to assert himself at my expense. That's quite a story. Well, I will tell you everything in detail, but in the meantime, please like, subscribe, and write a comment down below. Like I said, Evan and I had a great relationship. We're only 1.5 years apart in age, but I have grown, how should I put it, smarter, prettier, and even taller. We went to different schools, respectfully always, except for elementary school. Evan went to school first, then me, but I soon caught up with him quickly and jumped over the class. Thus, we became classmates. As soon as we started going to school together, the problem started. Evan started going to school less often. He avoided me and even stopped talking to me. Evan, what's wrong with you? Nothing, I'm just not in the mood. You want to go and play a game? We could go online or play something. By the way, on Saturday, Jude invited me over to his birthday. What should we get? I'm not going. Why not? He invited all his classmates. Fuck you, they won't even notice I'm gone. What makes you say that? Because I said I won't go. That was our first fight. My parents couldn't get him to confess either, and Evan almost stopped talking to me. He even moved to sleep in another room for guests. Of course, it all depressed me because I loved my brother so much. And then we moved to another state and my parents put us in different schools. Then I didn't understand why either. But I had a good life in the new place too. I made friends almost immediately, got into baseball, became a member of the sports team. Then came popularity. A muscular body, you get the idea. Girls were eager to get to know me. We were 16 by then. And Evan's life was kind of quiet. Sometimes I still invited him to parties and wanted to introduce him to girls, but my brother slowly drifted into a state of dull shit. And then I gave up and left him alone. The only thing that was actively changing with Evan was schools. He jumped from one to the other and could change 2 schools in a year. My parents were scratching their heads. They didn't know what to do about it. So I suggested one option. Evan, are you going to change schools again? Yeah, I don't like that school. Let's be honest, you don't like any school. No, I like the first one. I did too, but then you started avoiding people there. Do you have a problem or something? What do you care? Don't pretend like you care. But I do. No. Let's go to school, especially since it's the only one you haven't gone to yet. No thanks. But my parents thought it was best because I'm there and I can look after him. Evan ended up in my class. At first, everyone was surprised that we were related, because even in figure, Evan looked like a nerd. Though, hell yeah, he was skinny. We were the same height, but he was hunched over a lot. So one day, I forced him to go to a party with the guys. I wanted my brother to loosen up a little bit, so I gave him a beer. Half a bottle had made him feel like he had drunk a case. I took him under my arm and we went home. Get off me, you're disgusting. Disgusting? About what? I can see it, you're just dragging me around. What's the big deal? You're my brother. Yeah, right. You were always luckier. You were loved more. Mum praised more. Dad was more proud. I am so, although older, but unnecessary. What are you talking about? You're just drunk. No, I'm not drunk. I'm just sober. I'm not liked, but you are. You really think so? Yeah. Okay, let's do the opposite then. What do you mean? I'll raise your popularity at school tomorrow. It'll give you confidence, okay? Yeah, you've got a lot of it. Look, you're not born with confidence. You develop it. And I know how to do it. Do you think I'm perfect? Did you know I have a big complex? What's that? I never expose my torso because I have a heart-shaped birthmark. That's right, I forgot. That's hilarious. Exactly, so we're not all perfect. Okay, let's say, how do you do it? I have a plan. We came to school the next day and acted out a scene there. Like Evan and I had a big fight. I punched him once and he punched me. I pretended as I flew off a couple of meters. Evan came up to me and started kind of punching me in the face and stomach. I was screaming and begging for mercy. Evan got up and went into the classroom. And I was lying in the hallway, whimpering in pain. The guys were shocked, asking if I'd been beaten that badly. And I said they didn't know my brother yet. He's got demons inside him, and if you let them out, it would be very painful and bad. I was afraid of him all my childhood. He's the only one who knows the pain techniques and points of my body because he beat me all the time. That's why they kicked him out of schools and everybody was afraid of him. This legend was spread instantly because girls love bad boys. They immediately started going for him. I told them a couple of pickup tricks, and little by little, my brother began to straighten up, took off his glasses, put his lenses on, got a different haircut, and changed his style of dress. Not without my help, of course, and in just a couple of weeks, his life changed drastically. Evan became more popular than me. He was nicknamed the Tamer, like he could do everybody. Interestingly enough, everyone took us at our word and no one checked it out. I was sincerely happy for him until my friends went over to his side. That is to say, gradually all my friends left me, even the girls I was hanging out with. Of course, this began to stress me out. I mean, I was left alone and I didn't like it. Man, my last year of school, and it was such a mess. That's not how I wanted it to go. Not with that kind of glory. I'd been working on my reputation for years, and I didn't want my brother to ruin it. Especially not with my own plan. But things got out of hand. I mean, I would have been silently happy for him. But Evan wasn't just getting high on his reputation. He was trying to stifle mine, and sort of self-assert himself at my expense. Every day he came to school, socializing with my friends. Sometimes he would push me in the corridor with his elbow, and everyone laughed. I kept quiet. Sometimes he would take my food from the tray in the cafeteria without asking. Everyone laughed. I kept quiet again, and sometimes he would sit in my seat in the class. I would sit in another seat silently. Everyone laughed. I stayed silent, but slowly, I got mad. And then we had prom rehearsal. Evan got the hottest girl in the class. I was planning on going with her, but he beat me to it. The day before rehearsal, we had a big fight at home. He came into my room and took my shirt without asking. Evan, I know you do whatever you want at school, but we're at home now. I don't need the play. Do I detect a note of jealousy? What jealousy? I'm talking about conscience. Oh, so I've lived in the shadows most of my life, and you can't even last a couple of months. What does that have to do with whether I can or can't? I helped you to become a man, not a loser for the rest of your life. You think I couldn't have done it without you? Let's face it, no. What did you say? What did you hear? We had a little fight, but Mum noticed it in time. In the morning, we got to school without talking. Then rehearsal started. Evan was dancing and interfering with me, like accidentally tripping me or catching me with his shoulder. I freaked out. We clashed again and he pulled my shirt off. My birthmark was visible to everyone. And here's our Mr. Hart came into the chat room. My brother laughed. Everyone saw it. Everyone started pointing at me and laughing that I looked like a dog with a cute birthmark. I felt hurt and uncomfortable and left. In the evening at home, we continued to fight. Evan yelled that he was a person and could do without me, and I yelled that he would go around with nerds without my help. We didn't get anywhere. At the next rehearsal, when he was dancing with a very cool girl, all of a sudden a big guy walked in. He turned out to be her boyfriend. He saw her dancing with my brother and went at him like a fucking Terminator. Evan had terror in his eyes. He just knocked him out in one fell swoop. By the time I got there, my brother was already on the floor. So I grabbed at him, threw a couple of punches, knocked my fist out. It hurt like hell. He did beat me too at first, but then I punched him in the head and he passed out. Only then did the guards get there. We were both taken to the hospital, where Evan was told how I stood up for him. He came to my room. I'm sorry, I'm a retard. Yeah, retard. I'm sorry, brother, I'm ashamed. If it wasn't for you, he would have killed me. Brother for brother. I forgave him, of course, because I loved him. At homecoming, Evan came on stage. He was supposed to sing a song about the school, but he asked to change the music and sang a song written about me. It sang about how only his brother believed in him. Only his brother was always there for him and he didn't care. That only his brother was always supporting and protecting him. And that I was his family. The song touched everybody. So guys, whatever conflict you have in your family, deal with the problem first and only then decide what to do. We're doing good now. We went to the same college together, but now we have a different environment. No one humiliates anyone. On the contrary, in fact, we let everyone know that we stand up for each other.
My name is Edward. I think if you're reading this or watching it right now, I'm probably dead. Oh no, this is not a seance. I just left a detailed letter asking you to tell our story with my brother, so that it will inspire a little hope and kindness in your hearts, so that you don't forget that there is love and selflessness in the world. Share the story with your friends, write your opinion in the comments, and it'll make my family really happy. I'll start from the beginning. I have a family. Dad, Mom, and my brother Rick. The four of us lived in a small, beautiful town in England. Our family is very ordinary. My father works as a manager in a tea production company. My mother is a housewife. My brother and I went to school. I'm a year and a half younger than him, and maybe that's why we were friends. I remember once when my bike was taken away from me on the street. There were ordinary teenagers in the type of hooligans. My brother heard my cries for help for a kilometer probably. It turns out that he, too, was returning home at this time of the evening. When he got there in a couple of minutes, he stood up for me. And even though Rick wasn't a hero, he was a small boy with a heart condition. And he wasn't afraid of those guys. And he pounced as soon as he saw that I was scared. We both got it then. The bike was taken away from me, but then the police found it and returned it to me. This story got stuck in my mind, because then I knew for sure that Rick would do anything for me. Why is he ill? Rick was born with a heart condition, unfortunately. Our parents were very worried. Doctors did not give guarantee that he would live or not, but still survived. And after 1.5 years, I was born. I'm not well either. I have problems with my liver and kidneys. My brother and I need a transplant, but as you know, it's difficult to find donors, and it also costs a lot of money. My parents are strong people. They raised us no matter what. I know that my mother is worried about us more than anyone else, but unfortunately, it happened like this. I don't think it's anyone's fault. It just happens. It's life. We tried to be like everyone else. We went to school, hung out with friends, read books, went on weekends, celebrated Christmas and birthdays, but nevertheless, we carried piles of pills in special bags. This has already become a way of life for us. We did not particularly spread out diseases, so as not to cause pity, we tried our best to keep the bar, as they say. And we seemed to be doing pretty well. We had friends, and Ricky even seemed to have a romantic relationship. That year, a cool winter came, and we decided to go to the mountains with friends. The guys just loved skiing and snowboarding, but we just wanted to get some air. I didn't see the argument between Ricky and another guy. I was out of the house at that time. When I came back, I saw Ricky going for a snowboard ride. I tried to talk him out of it. I knew it was a bad idea. The guys didn't know about the disease, but I did. But Ricky was angry. It was a stupid argument and nothing more, but he wasn't listening to me. Rick climbed up on the board and chose a descent that wasn't for beginners. In general, everything turned out badly, of course. He fell, lost his balance, and rolled down. And so that he did not crash into a tree, I ran to him to catch or at least change the path. It was a bad idea. He crashed into me, and we both got hurt, and then went to hospital. It turns out that Ricky hit his chest on my legs, which caused heart complications. My parents didn't tell me the rest, but I went through my brother's card while he was sleeping. Ricky was dying, just like me. We both knew that without the transplant, we were not residents. But now my brother has less time to hope. Our parents were looking for a donor, but there was no options. First, I helped with the search. Then one night, I went to his room. I couldn't sleep, and I saw that he was not breathing. His heart had stopped. I called for help. I screamed. I cried. The doctors kicked me out of the room and told me to call my parents, but there was very little time, and there was no donor. I thought it was time to implement my plan. I wrote my parents a message to come, ran to the ward, took the necessary documents, and went to the doctor. Naturally, he said that he wanted to see my parents so that I could become a donor for my brother. So he decided to take fate into his own hands. There is no heroism or desire to be perpetuated by a good deed. And I repeat, my brother would have done the same for me. I have less chance of survival than he does. As you may have guessed, I signed the documents when I read the card to become my brother's donor. I have bad kidneys and liver, but a healthy heart. When I saw that he wasn't breathing, I knew I couldn't live without him, knowing that I had a chance to save Rick. Knowing full well that my parents would not allow me to take this step, I took some pills to help me become a donor. I'll go to sleep and not wake up. It won't hurt, I'm sure. Just now I had time to write all this. Well, Rick will probably tell you what happened next. When I came to my senses, the first thing that I saw was my parents. They were happy and sad at the same time. I immediately felt that something was wrong and asked about my brother. Where's Ed? On such a simple question, My mother burst into tears. My father bit his lip, and I suddenly felt some warmth in my chest area. I understood everything without words, and it caused me so much pain. Even though his heart was beating inside of mine, I was still alive. It's hard to describe how I felt at that moment. I was angry at him and myself. I was angry at the circumstances, at life and the doctors. But what happened is happened. One thing I knew for sure was that my brother did it because he believed I wouldn't just waste my life. Since he gave me a second chance, I must live and be happy. This is what I promised myself and my parents. Well, after I was discharged from the hospital, the doctor handed me an envelope right on the day of discharge. There was a letter that I read to you. My brother and I once made a vow to each other that if we managed to survive by whitewashing our illnesses, we would definitely teach other children to look at themselves differently, teach them to love life the way we do. I kept my promise. First of all, after rehabilitation and recovery, I started studying, attended paid courses in law and management, entered medical school, and studied long and hard. I became a volunteer of Goodwill and helped children whose lives were already on the edge from birth, like Ed and me. Every day I try to do something useful, and if I succeed, I feel that pleasant warmth in the chest area.